It's been a very interesting case in the state of Alabama where Judge Roy Moore, who presides over a circuit court, in this courtroom a wood-carved plaque containing the Ten Commandments. He was challenged by another judge to take those down. The governor of Alabama, Fob James, has stated that he will do whatever it takes to keep the Ten Commandments up in that courtroom, including calling in the National Guard. It is sure to be an entertaining debate tomorrow and very interesting, and I believe a very important debate. But sadly, the entertainment's going to come from those people who will come to the floor to try to twist history, try to continue the revision of history that would separate the country from its heritage. You know, we have a very proud heritage of faith and freedom in this country. In fact, on the issue of the Ten Commandments, we had James Madison, the father of the Constitution, say the following while drafting the Constitution. Madison said, "We have staked the entire future of the American civilization not upon the power of government, but upon the capacity of the individual to govern himself, control himself, and sustain himself according to the Ten Commandments of God." That was James Madison, the father of the Constitution. And yet, 220 years later, we have radical revisionists who were trying to tell us that the Constitution will not allow us to have the Ten Commandments on the wall of a court in Alabama. And it is a radical notion. Look, for instance, at the Supreme Court itself, which has two versions of the Ten Commandments up on its walls. Look on this House chamber. Right on the back wall is a picture of one of the great lawmakers in the history of this republic. And when this great building was being built, it was Moses that was put front center in this chamber. So every speaker would see the face of Moses on the back wall. But sadly, over the past 30 years, these radical revisionists have been doing everything that they could do to make the radical seem conventional. And worse yet, to make the conventional seem radical. It's what Charles Krauthammer calls defining deviancy up. And for the radicals, it's not important enough for them to define deviancy down and make deviant behavior seem normal. But as Judge Bork has said, their most important goal is to make normal behavior seem radical. Now, for the judges that would like to step forward and talk about how Fob James has no right to decide what is on the walls of his courtrooms in the state of Alabama, I can only say that they need to read what the founders said, attorneys themselves. It was Thomas Jefferson who said, "I consider the government of the United States as not allowed by the Constitution from intermeddling with religious institutions, their doctrines, their disciplines, or their exercises. This results not only from the provision that no law shall be made respecting the establishment of free exercise of religion, but also that which reserves to the states the powers not delegated to this federal government. Certainly no power to prescribe any religious exercise or assume authority in any religious discipline has been delegated to the federal government. It must then rest with the states." And Justice Joseph Story, in his commentaries on the Constitution, the first commentary on the Constitution written by a founder, said this: "The whole power over the subject of religion is left exclusively to state governments to be acted upon according to their own sense of justice and the state constitutions." It is a matter well within the right of any governor to determine whether a Ten Commandments shall be on the wall of courtrooms or not, and whether the radical revisionists of the past 30 years wish to continue to disconnect America from the beliefs of Madison and Jefferson and Washington. It's up to them. But we have got to stop reviving history and stand up today and say enough is enough. If you want to build a bridge to the 21st century, you do it, but you don't do it by cutting America off from its proud, faithful past.
Gentleman's time has expired. Thank you.